Hello, my name is Rodney. I'm from the PL Gamer Kyogen YouTube channel. And today I'm doing another Gaming Memories episode. This time I'm going to focus on a console that I got when I was younger. I believe I bought this console in probably 1996, maybe 95, 96 era. And that is the Panasonic 3DO. This is the FZ10 model. I bought this, I want to say in Tennessee. I can't remember exactly. It's been quite some time. I'm not looking up dates or anything like that. I'm going from memory. So if I get dates wrong, I'm sorry. But I believe most of my dates will be pretty close to what really happened. But the story behind the how I got this and why I got it. Well, at the time I bought mine, they hadn't stopped production. They were still being made. Or maybe they had planned on stopping, or maybe there are rumors, but I'm not really sure. I remember going to a game store, actually reading a bunch of magazines, and reading about the M2, which was kind of an add-on for it. There's actually an expansion slot. If I can take the cover off. I don't know if I've ever taken this cover off or not. There we are. Yeah, there's actually an expansion slot on the side that you take this off that you can add, as they had that was for the M2, which I believe it was going to be like the Sega CD, and this is going to sit on top of it. The M2 is going to add more functionality to it, more capabilities. I'm not really sure how it's going to update. I just remember that the M2 is supposed to, and there's a few demos out for it that I remember people have found over the years and have seen. I don't have any of those, which, I mean, they're very rare, and I think they're extremely expensive, but that's one reason why I picked it up. I'm actually going to hang up a cord here. But I remember going into the game store, and the guy was like, oh, yeah, they had a few of, and they had marked the price, slashed the prices really, really low, and I thought is they were trying to get people to get this so they could buy the M2. But I believe a lot of people already knew that they were just going to stop making them. So I believe I paid maybe $150 to $200 for it. I'm not sure. I think around $150, maybe $200, I'm not sure. But yeah, something around that. And I got a few games. Got it home, played it, and loved it. I had so much fun with my 3DO. Well, maybe a few months passed, and they announced they weren't going to make anymore. The M2 was canceled, and not making the 3DO anymore. And I was like, crap, I really wanted to get the M2. But, I was like, that sucks. Well, my brother me and my brother and my family go to Walmart, and they have 3DO games, and they actually have the console for like $50 or $100. And I was like, what? So my brother, this is my brother's console, he picks up the ZF1, which is the first model, which has the sliding out drawer and everything. This one still works. I know a lot of people say they have issues with not working. This one still works. The expansion door on his is missing. I'm not sure if over the years it's just probably gotten broken off somehow. But, yeah. On the back, this is kind of cool because this console actually had the composite, S-video, and it had RF out. It had so many things on it, and you didn't have to use special cables. You just actually could plug the cable straight in, like if you get from Walmart or Radio Shack, anywhere like that. Actually, that's on both of them. They both had S-video, RF, and composite. So yeah, but I was like, man, that sucks that he got his for so much cheaper. But we got, probably about 20 games that year because they were just so cheap. And Walmart bought the overstock or leftover stock. I'm not sure what you'd call it, but they bought what was that other places couldn't sell, and they sold them in their store. And we got some. I remember getting so many games that we played. motorcycles hitting each other. Road Rash. Took me forever to remember the name of that game. But we played that. It had Soundgarden did the music for it. And it was just, it was awesome. I mean, I remember playing that game for so long. And then the Need for Speed, the first one, it's on the 3DO. And it's not like the new, it's not like the new ones, but it's like you had this guy in between races that talked to you. It's so cheesy, but it was great. I loved it. And there's a game called A Mercenary. Actually, yeah, that's actually what's in my 3DO. It's a game called A Mercenary. It's just so many games that aren't there really good. What was that game? The first-person shooter. I actually did a video on my YouTube channel. Ah, oh, I forgot the name of it. Killing Time. That, I mean, it was the beginning, like, when you're trying to play first-person shooters on a console. So you had issues. You had issues with, like, controls and everything. So the controls weren't the greatest. But it's just awesome. So when you're doing things, at the time it was awesome. If I play it now, I'm like, oh man, the controls aren't that good. Plus, you're playing the D-pad. You didn't play with analog sticks on this. If I had one of the controllers here right next to me, I'd show it to you, but they're in a box over here. Because I have all my controllers. I'm trying to sort out my game room right now. That's the reason why I'm not showing you anything over here, because there's a big mess. But yeah, it's actually, I really love this system. Because when I got this system, I believe in 95, 96, I believe that was still around the time of the Super Nintendo and Genesis. So going from that to this was a huge jump. I mean, it was just crazy when you look at it. So, but yeah, we had so much fun with it. Me and my brother would stay up all night. Like when I just had mine, we would stay up and play it for a long. There's actually this one game I got, Zadnauts, The People's Party, and it's this cheesy game show. Basically, it starts out where you're like in a communist country, and the game show's rigged. And then, like, the revolution happens, and the revolution takes over the game show. It's all colorful and everything. And by the end of the game show, the Communist Party's taken back over. So it's really crazy. And one of the things about this console was the reason why the console was sold so expensive is that they didn't do licensing fees on the games like Nintendo does, or most companies do now. They needed to make the money off the hardware. They need to make the money back. Because what they did is they sold the development kit. It is really expensive. It's like you could, anybody could buy the development kit and make games for it. It's just that that you paid actually what the thing was worth. Because if you actually look at how much an Xbox One or PS4 costs to make, and what you're actually paying for it, you're paying a lot less. But this, you pay, I think it was like $700-$800 when it first came out. And you, basically, that was the cost of what it was to produce the system. But the games, those were they didn't license those. So if you bought the development kit, you made your game and put it out. Then, that's one of the reasons they tried to do. They wanted to do it that way to make game companies come and actually produce games for it. But there wasn't a lot of game companies didn't come to it. But it, oh man, just so much fun. So many memories. And the fact that these two are, that this one is mine and this one is my brother's, is that's actually really special to me, because these are actually the ones that we played on. Oh, if you notice one thing. It only has one controller port on this. And you're like, wait, you said you and your brother played it together. Yeah, well, that's kind of weird. What you do is, on the top of the controller, there was a another port. So basically, you daisy change the controllers together. Well, I mean, look, man, I know I got a controller here. Oh, sweet. Oddly enough, it was right on top. So yeah, this is a 3DO controller. You can this is my brother's. The reason why you can tell it's why that is because the one that came with the original one had a headphone jack and a volume knob. The one that came with mine did not have that. Which is kind of cool. I mean, think now it's like, oh, the Xbox One, you can plug headphones into the controller if you have the stereo adapter and listen to it that way, or same thing with the PlayStation 4. Well, you had that capability in 1995 with the 3DO. Also, right here, you can see it here. This is your second controller port. So you plugged, can't grab the end of it. Plug that to your 3DO. Plug player 2 into player 1 controller. Player 3 plugs into the player 2 controller, and so on and so on. But yeah, like, that's one of the things about this controller. It only had 5 buttons. Well, I'm not counting the start and play button, stop and play, or X and P as it's labeled. But yeah, you had 3 buttons here, 2 shutter buttons. And it's kind of cool, though, but also that you actually, if you wanted to use, because I think these played VCDs. I'm not sure about that. They did play music CDs. I don't know that. And if you want, all the buttons are actually labeled what they did. Like play, stop, you had your next track and fast forward buttons. And around there actually has those labeled. But another thing that's kind of cool, they actually have put a little indent on the B button. So that your thing, you know, so if you're not looking at the controller, you can tell which button's which. So like your B button has the indent, and to the left is A and to the right is C. But yeah. It's actually a really cool controller. I like the shape of it. It feels similar to a SNES controller, but a little bit bigger. Also, the way these little things sit here, your fingers kind of rest there naturally. And I always liked it. It always felt really well, fit really comfortable in my hand. I actually have another controller that came with my Zadnauts People's Party game, which stopped working a long time ago. But I'm not really sure where it's at now. I think it's in another box. So like I keep my broken controllers in another box. But yeah, this game system holds a lot of memories for me. A lot of the stuff that me and my brother did together was, I mean, a lot of things we did when we were younger. We played video games together. We played outside. But this, I remember, was one of the things that really brought, that me and him played together for a long time, because we had never seen anything like this before. We were used to the Super Nintendo, and going from that to this was just, like I said, was dramatic. But yeah. Oh, mine actually has it says manufactured July 1995 on the bottom of mine, right there. I wonder if this one has one on it. I'd actually never noticed that before. This one does not have a sticker on it. No, it doesn't. Well, there's a serial number, but it does not have the manufactured sticker number on it. That's very interesting. But yeah, that's really cool. I never actually knew about that. That's actually awesome to know when it was manufactured. But that is a kind of brief history on my gaming history, talking about the 3DO and the things that me and my brother did. I'm actually going to talk about some of the games for the 3DO next time, because I know that there's so many of them. We got Dragon's Lair, Killing Time, Brain Dead 13, and I mean, a lot of these games that come out, they did come out on other systems, but not just 3DO. But really, the 3DO was the best version of them. I haven't found a better version of Road Rash than the 3DO. The music and everything that was in it, like the original Need for Speed, I don't think there was a better version. So, like Dragon's Lair, there's really good versions of it out, but the one on the 3DO is phenomenal. Brain Dead 13, another one. I think it's superior to the PlayStation version. I've played both of them, and I really enjoy the one on the 3DO better. I don't know if it's maybe it's the controller I'm more used to or what, but it's just, I really enjoyed it. But I'm actually tying my controller. I use Velcro strips, and I was actually tying my controller up. I know, the perfect time to do it right on camera, right? But hope you guys are enjoying the videos. I will be back more with some more gaming memories. Hope you enjoyed it, and till next time. Thank you for watching my video. If you liked the video, go ahead and give me a like. If you'd like to see more from me, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. I release at least 2 videos a week. Most of the time I release more. Leaving a comment actually helps me a lot. It helps me know what you'd like, dislike, or would like to see on my channel. So go ahead and leave me a comment. If you would like to get in touch with me, have any questions, anything like that, you can go ahead and email me at vmail@pogamer.com. You can also follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. As always, thank you for watching. Until next time.